welcome here to TalkFCB and welcome back to the channel, guys. Of course, Cannon here after a vital, vital win yesterday against Elche. It was so, so important that we found a way to get the 3 points. And in today's video, I'm going to bring you here some reaction from Xavi and some really strong words, I've got to say, after yesterday's game. We're also going to be talking about Gavi, about his magical performance, and importantly, his contract situation too. And on that note as well, we're going to be discussing Dembele, his impact yesterday, and what the future holds for him, and the treatment received by Frenkie de Jong at the Camp Nou, and what that could mean for his future, as there truly is plenty to get through, so let's get to it. But I want to start first of all by illustrating just how important those 3 points were yesterday at the Camp Nou, because as you can see, this is the league table. Now, yes, on the face of it, we do remain there in seventh position here, heading into Sunday now and the games to come. But as you can see, after Sevilla's victory over Atletico, we now stand just 2 points behind Atletico Madrid and just 3 points off the top four. And this is ahead of our game in hand in midweek, coming against Sevilla, as we remain very much in the fight for those top four positions. But this is the interesting part for me, because like I say, yesterday was a vital win. I think the way that we got it there with a brilliant first half, of course we conceded two really poor goals, but then winning it with just a few minutes to go, you could understand after the game if Xavi was in really buoyant mood, if he was saying, you know, everything is going well here, we're moving in the right direction. And yes, he did praise all of those young players. He was so, so happy with the impact that they had, but also he gave out a strong message, and I think this is a really, really key message that actually we've been saying, all of us fans, for a long, long time. Because Xavi said, I haven't been here for 6 years now, but he said there's some things within the club that really surprised me. He said, I'm talking tactically. He said the majority of the players here don't understand positional play. And he said, these are things that I understood from the age of 11, that coming through, you understand, you know how to play in this team. But he said, we've got players here who've never worked on this. They've never been taught how to play in this way. He said, I don't know who's responsible. He said, obviously, like I say, I haven't been here, you know, previous coaches, all of that kind of stuff. But he said, what I am seeing right now is a real surprise to me. And that is music to my ears. Because how many times have we come after bad games, after bad performances, and we've said, these players don't know how to play at Barça. There are many, many players who haven't been coached to play in the way we need, in the way that we want. They don't understand their role. They don't understand where they need to be. And that is why Xavi now, of course, he's come in as the coach. Of course, there's been good results. There's been bad results. There's been good performances. There's been bad. But this is going to take time, because there is a lot in this team that has been taken away over the past few years, that previous coaches have basically ignored what this club stands for. It will take time to get that back. But quite clearly, Xavi is well aware of what needs to change. And I do think, guys, honestly right now, when you're looking at the players that we have, when you're looking at yesterday's game, those kind of performances, you're looking at that and you're thinking, actually, the players who understand this club most, who understand how and what it takes to play in a Barcelona team, it's the younger ones. It is the players there who've come through the system, who've worked at La Masia, who get the club, who've been taught from a young age how to be. They are the ones right now carrying us through this turbulent time. And one of those, of course, the star that's breaking through, it's Gavi. Yesterday, once again, it's actually difficult at times to find the words that describe him, because his level, the kind of quality that he's showing, it is staggering. It is beyond belief for me that a 17-year-old player can come through and play like this, because he is absolutely outstanding in every area. Whether it's him defending, whether it's him in a one versus one duel, whether it's him making up ground, creating space, moving away from defenders. You saw him yesterday for the goal. He can do everything. There is absolutely no ceiling on what this young man can achieve. And of course, for that reason, we want him around for a long, long time. And I do know that many of us Barcelona fans are just starting to get a little bit twitchy, a little bit nervous there when you're hearing in the media about Chelsea, about Liverpool being ready to pay Gavi's current release clause, which is 50 million euros. Right now he has a contract until 2023. And until we renew him, any club could come in, pay that clause, and Barca would have no choice but to accept. But the reassuring part is, Gavi's the one who decides. Gavi will decide his future. And Barca, is Gavi's home. He joined La Masia there at the age of 11 back in 2015. This is the club here where he belongs, where he's grown up. And you look at a game like yesterday at the Camp Nou there, performing at that kind of level in that way. That's what he's always dreamed of, playing in front of Barca fans in that stadium. And you saw exactly what it meant to him with that celebration, what it means every time that he steps out on the field as a Barcelona player. And that's why I think all of us fans, we want that new contract ASAP. We want him renewed. We want him signing on the dotted line, but I think we all believe that is going to happen. This is where he wants to be. Barca right now is said to be very confident of wrapping up that new deal. They're hoping to do it very, very soon. And when we do renew Gavi, he's going to have a very similar, if not exactly the same, release clause there as Ansu Fati and as Pedri, as he is a player that can make history here, and we want him for many, many years to come. And of course, speaking of contract situations, that brings me nicely on to Ousmane Dembélé. But first of all, I really do have to commend him, actually, for his performance against Elche yesterday. Obviously, he got the assist for the first goal there, the header from the corner for Ferran Jukla. But actually, I want to just highlight here the fact that throughout that first half, Dembélé could have had three more assists on top of that. He could have easily ended that first half with four assists to his name. And honestly, it's not an exaggeration. The balls that he was playing, and I'm not just talking here about long, aimless passes, hoping for the best. These were really precise, phenomenal playmaking from Dembélé. And it's, again, another example of what he can do, what he is capable of. And you do look around our team, and you look at Dembélé, and you do often think, he is different. He does give you a different option. He can be the match winner. He can be a player there who can make such a phenomenal impact. But the only problem for me right now, watching that kind of display yesterday, for me at least, it's difficult to get excited. It's difficult to really get behind Dembélé and think, you know what, that's amazing. You're our player. You are somebody that we can really count on, because we don't know if he sees his future here. We don't know if he even wants to be here. And until that contract situation is sorted out, it's tough to get too excited about these kind of performances. Now, Xavi says right now that he's confident, that he's spoken a lot with Dembélé, that Dembélé has assured him that he's really happy here. But the club and Xavi keep saying it's about that representative. It's about that agent there finding a way to agree that contract, those terms with Dembélé's agent. And as of right now, we are no closer to knowing if he's going to stay, if he's going to go. And the question that I would ask you guys right now, it seems to change week by week, day by day, but if you were in charge right now at the club, would you be making every effort to get Dembélé renewed? Would you be putting real pressure on him, trying to convince him, trying to do all that you can do to keep him here? Or do you not see Dembélé's future at this club? And finally, we do indeed move on to the future and the situation of Frenkie de Jong at Barcelona. And this one is just as interesting, because right now, again, the question marks are there. Because even yesterday, he started the game against Elche. He was in Xavi's start. And I thought that he had a decent game. I think, obviously, he was overshadowed by Gavi, by Nico when he came on as well. And Xavi even admitted that there in his post-match press conference. That, you know what, de Jong is doing what he can right now. He's not really feeling maybe 100%, but he's out there giving his best. You can never ever doubt that commitment from De Jong, because he has played so many minutes throughout the season so far. But I was honestly amazed, and not in a good way, absolutely shocked for me, when De Jong was indeed subbed off on the 76th minute. That wasn't the shocking part, but it was what came after that. Because from the stands, he was whistled yesterday. De Jong walking off the pitch there, yes at 2-2, yes the team were not doing well, but to whistle Frenkie De Jong, I thought that was ridiculous. Honestly, guys, you know, I know we've heard it for several players this season, but De Jong? Really? Is he the player that you want to single out right now and actually whistle? That really, really did puzzle and very much confuse me here to hear that reaction. And it just makes things more complicated. It just makes things now even more blown up. The fact that De Jong, of course, is going through this rough spell, this rough patch. There's plenty of questions about his future, whether Barca are going to cash in on him and try and get a big offer in the coming transfer windows. But according to De Jong's father, that's not going to happen. He spoke just a few days earlier in the week. He said, look, they're currently building a new house. You know, Frenkie, Mickey, they're really happy in the city. They're really enjoying Barcelona. All the people are so kind to them. They're so welcoming. And he said, for Frenkie, the only opinion that matters is the one from the coach. And they all really like him over there. And from what we've heard from Xavi, he's certainly a big backer of Frenkie de Jong. He certainly sees him as a big, big part of his team and somebody who can contribute more. but he's sure that he'll get there. And I just thought yesterday those whistles to really single out De Jong, that was very, very strange for me. But of course, guys, football is very much a matter of opinions, and that is why I am always looking to you guys. So let me know what you think in the comments down below there on Xavi's words, of course, about players not understanding positional play at Barcelona. What do you make there of Gavi's contract situation? Do you believe that Dembele will renew? And of course, on Frenkie de Jong and that reception at the Camp Nou yesterday, what did you make of all that? Please do let me know, of course, all of those thoughts down below, and I will see you very soon as we build up to that massive game against Sevilla. Thank you indeed for watching, guys, and thank you for supporting. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, but until next time, as always, Visca, El Barça!